Rated M for mature.
Shield the tribe and shield Noag. Those were Chieftain Narjak's last words to his cub Akrog after a ballista bolt from the Tusk Hunters pierced right through his chest. Fabled warrior, leader of the Moonkin trolls, last of the mythical Firstborn, killed by elven poachers. It was not only Narjak's heart that bolt impaled that day, but also that of the Moonkin tribe, weakened by the terrible blood rot plague and decimated by the hunters. They had long been struggling for survival. With their mighty chieftain gone, the last ray of hope still shining was Noag, Akrog's younger sibling who had inherited Narjak's legendary power. The chieftain's wish for Akrog to succeed him surprised many kin, but it surprised Akrog most of all. True, he was a strong and honorable warrior, but far from the Moonkin's best. All he had was the peculiar gift to hear the voices of the dead, and an iron will to do right by his sire's last words. Was he ready for this? He could not say. Yet when the tribe demands, a troll must bow. And so Akrog found himself giving his first command as a chieftain-to-be. The Moonkin would travel to Mugwa's cradle, a shrine guarded by the Bonekin trolls, to perform the devouring, the sacred ritual where the new chieftain consumed the old chieftain's heart to take up his role. This story begins the day the bruised tribe arrived at the cradle, where Akrog, joined by his mentor Grunwar and his trusted one Saska, ventured out to find a holy plant for the ritual, Mugwar's Tear. Little did Akrog know that the true trial of the Moonkin trolls had just begun.